Good morning. I am going to discuss two important regulations made under Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. One is Food Product Standards and Additive Regulations, and another is Contaminants, Toxins and Residues Regulation 2011. These two regulations deal with food safety and quality standards. Now, first let us discuss food product standards. There are 12 categories of food products having different products prescribed vertical standards like product description and physical, chemical and organoleptic parameters of individual product, and horizontal standards for additives prescribed under Appendix A and microbial parameters prescribed under Appendix B. Under physical parameters like color, appearance, etc., and chemical parameters include total soluble solid, acidity, total ash, and organoleptic parameters include taste and flavor, etc. Now, coming to standards, there are many standards I already mentioned prescribed under the regulations. I will touch upon one or two from some of the categories. Number one is dairy products. First one is milk, whether it is raw milk, pasteurized milk or boiled milk or sterilized milk. The type of milk, there are different milk like buffalo milk, cow milk, goat, sheep milk, mixed milk, and also there are toned milk, double toned milk or full cream milk. For buffalo milk, it is 5 to minimum percentage of milk fat is 5 and 6%, and minimum percentage of milk solids, not fat, it is 9%. The 5% and 6% variation is due to variation of fat content in different states. Some of the states like Assam, Bihar, Delhi, Gujarat, Maharashtra, the fat content found to be higher, so it is kept 6%. And rest of the states minimum fat content is 5%. Similarly, for cow milk, it varies from 3 to 3.5 and even 4%, and milk solid fat it is 8.5%. Total fat content of 3% found to in two states, Odisha and Mizoram, and as high as 4% in states like three states of Chandigarh, Haryana and Punjab, and rest of the states it is 3.5%. Goat and sheep milk minimum percentage of fat is 3% and SNF 9%. Mixed milk it is 4.5% milk fat, and solid not fat is 8.5%. Now coming to paneer, type of paneer is normal paneer or low fat paneer. Maximum moisture content in normal paneer is 70% and milk fat content is 50%. For low fat paneer, maximum percentage of moisture is 70% and maximum milk fat is 15%. In case of low fat paneer, the same should be declared on the label that it is low fat paneer. Now coming to processed cheese, it shall have pleasant flavor, taste and free from rancidity and conforms to following standards. There are parameters like moisture, it is maximum 60%, and milk fat content on dry basis, a maximum is 40%. Now coming to standard of butter, the table butter, there are two types of butter, one is table butter and another is normal butter. The table butter to be obtained from pasteurized or pre-boiled milk to ensure microbiological safety. The butter should be free from animal or vegetable fat, mineral oil, added flavor and rancidity, and it should have good taste and flavor. Butter should meet also following standards. There are two types of butters I've already mentioned, table butter and cooking butter. The maximum moisture content for table butter is 16% and minimum milk fat content is 80%. The solid not fat maximum is 1.5% mass by mass, and common salt maximum is 3% mass by mass basis. For cooking butter, there is no standard specified for moisture content, but minimum milk fat content should be 76%, and there is no standard specified for solid not fat or common salt for your cooking butter. Now coming to another product under fats and oils, sunflower seeds oil, it is commonly sold in the market. The product shall obtain by solvent extraction from clean and sound sunflower seeds or cake from plants. It shall be clear, free from rancidity and foreign matter. It shall conform to the standards given in the table. These are the standards for sunflower oil. Refractometer reading at 40 degrees centigrade, it is 57 to 65, and iodine value 100 to 145. The iodine value indicates the more is the iodine value, the more is the unsaturation. It is indication of unsaturated oil. Saponification value is 188 to 194. Unsaponifiable matter is maximum 1.5%. Acid value is maximum 6. Now coming to another oil, it is palm oil. This is also commonly sold in the market. The product obtained by solvent extraction from fresh fruits of oil palm tree, free from rancidity, suspended particles or foreign matter, it shall conform to following standards. The butyl refractometer reading at 40 degrees centigrade is 33.3 to 39.5, iodine value 10 to 23, saponification value 235 to 255, unsaponified matter maximum 1.2%, acid value maximum 6. So if the palm oil is mixed with sunflower oil, it can be determined by the iodine value. Fruit juices, the juice is extracted by mechanical means from sound and ripened fruits, free from any objectionable flavor. It should have sweet and pleasant flavor and taste. Standards of some thermally processed fruit juices are given in the table. The different type of fruit juices like apple, orange or pineapple, grape juice, etc. Minimum total soluble solid should be 10% and maximum acidity 3.5%. Added sugar or nutritive sweetener, it 50 gram per kg. Lemon juice, minimum total soluble solid 6%, maximum acidity 4%, and maximum added sugar or nutritive sweetener is 200 gram per kg. Black currant, minimum total soluble solid 11%, maximum acidity 3.5%, and maximum added sugar or nitrate sweetener is 200 gram per kg. Mango, guava or other pulpy juices, minimum total solubility 15%, maximum acidity 3.5%, and added sugar should be added as per good manufacturing practices. Other acidic fruits like amla, jamun, etc., the minimum total solubility solid 10%, maximum acidity 3.5%, and added sugar maximum 200 gram per kg. Now coming to the another vegetable product is tomato ketchup. It should be prepared from fresh mature tomatoes or tomato puree paste prepared from juices with nutritive sweeteners like sugar, spices and condiments having characteristic flavor and taste. It shall conform to following standards. Minimum total soluble solids mass versus mass is 25%, and minimum acetic acid is 1%. Another fruit product is fruit jam. It should be prepared from sound, ripe fruits or frozen dehydrated fruits or fruit pulps having characteristic flavor and taste. It should be free from bran flavor and crystallization. Normally we find that in the preparation of jam, it is not prepared properly, there is a crystal formation. And also another characteristics of jam should be proper, gel formation should be proper. It is consistency should be good. It shall conform to following standards. Minimum fruit content should be 45%. Minimum fruit content in case of berry fruit like strawberry or raspberry, it is 25%. And minimum total soluble solid mass by mass, it is 65%. If it is less than 65%, there may be a problem in preservation, because above 65% normally fungal or mold growth is not occurred. So it should be ensured that a minimum total soluble solid of jam should be above 65%. Under cereal products, one important product is corn flakes. It is a breakfast cereal. It should be prepared from dehulled, degermed and cooked corn by flaking, partially drying and toasting. Now, it shall be form of crisps, uniform in size and golden brown color. It shall be free from dirt, insect larva and impurities. It shall conform to following standards. It is given in the table. Maximum moisture content is 7.5%. If it is more than that, there will be problem in preservation. Total ash maximum on dry basis is 1%. Ash insoluble in dilute sulfuric hydrochloric acid is maximum 1%. Alcoholic acidity with 95% alcohol, maximum 2 ml in 1 normal sodium hydroxide per 100 gram of dry substance. Another product under cereal is bread. It is commonly used by every household. The bread should be prepared from good quality of wheat flour. It should be free from insect larvae and foreign matter or coloring substances. It shall be free from fungal or insect growth. It shall conform to following standards. Alcoholic acidity with 90% of alcohol, maximum equivalent to 7.5 ml of 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide per 100 gram of dry substance. Ash insoluble dilute sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid is 25%. Coming to another product under chocolate confectionery, it is chocolate. There are some characteristics of chocolate. It should be prepared from cocoa powder and it should be free from vegetable oil or fat. There are other characteristics like total fat minimum on dry basis for milk chocolate, it should be 25%. In case of plain cocoa chocolate, it should be also 25%, and blended chocolate 25%. For all cases, minimum percentage of fat should be 25%. Milk fat on dry basis, in case of milk chocolate, it is 2%, and all other cases, plain chocolate or blended chocolate, there is no specified standard. Cocoa solids minimum on dry basis. In case of milk chocolate, it is 2.5%, and plain chocolate, it is 12%, and blended chocolate, it is 3%. Now, coming to another regulations, that is food additives. The additives are substances not normally consumed as food, but added to food for some technological purposes. For example, citric acid or acetic acid, it is added to food to maintain pH, or thickening agent is added to improve the consistency of food, or any processing aid is added. For example, in case of yogurt or dahi, lactic acid added for fermentation purposes. and also for organoleptic purposes like flavor and color and taste. So there are many additives. There are like thickening agent, coloring matters, preservatives, sweetening agents, or processing aids. Earlier, there are 800 food additives prescribed under food safety and standards regulation. These have been raised to 11,000 by recent notification by FSSAI. Limit of food additive for each category or subcategory of food has been prescribed. Some harmless additives such as citric acid, ascorbic acid, pectin, etc. are given in good manufacturing table. This can be added as per good manufacturing practice. There is no limit for these additives. So limit for some additives commonly used in food products is given. For example, limit for coloring matter for jam, jelly or marmalades. Alora red maximum 100 ppm, sunset yellow maximum 200 ppm, tartrazine it is yellow color, it is maximum 200 ppm, and fast green it is 200 ppm. There are also other coloring matter. I have given only 4 for different shade. Cocoa and chocolates it is 100 for all type of additives, all type of color. Alora red, sunset yellow, tartrazine or fast green. Sauces and ketchup, only alora red and sunset yellow are allowed of maximum 100 ppm. And in case of breakfast cereal, only alora red is allowed 100 ppm, no other color after of these three. Of course, some natural colors like beta carotene carotenes are permitted almost all food products. Water based flavored drinks 100 ppm for these 4 types of colors. Now coming to another additives commonly used for preservation. It is actually food preservatives, not color. Jam, jelly, marmalade, it is 100 ppm for sulfur dioxide. Benzoic acid it is 1000 ppm and sorbate it is 1000 ppm. Cocoa and chocolates for benzoic acid it is 1500 ppm and sorbic acid 1000 ppm. Sauces, ketchup, etc. 300 ppm and benzoate it is 1000 ppm and sorbate 1000 ppm. Breakfast cereal no preservative is allowed. Water based flavored drinks 70 ppm for sulfur dioxide and benzoic acid 600 ppm and sorbic acid 500 ppm. Now coming to microbial requirements for some products, I have given fruits and vegetable products. For thermally processed fruits and vegetable product, parameter is total plate count. It is not less than 50 per ml. Dehydrated fruits total plate count is not less than it should be less than 50 colony forming unit. Frozen food total plate count less than 40,000 per gram. All foods and vegetable products cover under FSSAI's regulation 2.3. Salmonella, Shigella, Clostridium botulinum or Staphylococcus aureus, all are pathogens. They should be absent in 20 gram of product. Now coming to microbial requirement for seafood. Seafood is a large quantity of seafood is exported from India and lot of consignment has been rejected due to microbial count, particularly pathogens. So in case of seafood, the microbial standards are to be strictly followed. Frozen shrimps, in case of raw frozen shrimps, total plate count should be less than 5 lakhs per gram. E. coli is less than 20 per gram. Staphylococcus aureus less than 100 per gram. And Salmonella or Shigella or Listeria monocytogen should be absent in 25 gram. Cooked fish products it should be less than 1 lakh per gram TPC, E. coli absent in 25 gram, Staphylococcus aureus absent in 25 gram, and also the pathogen Salmonella enterica should be absent in 25 gram. Salted fish TPC less than 5 lakhs per gram, E. coli less than 20 per gram, Staphylococcus aureus less than 100 per gram, and pathogen Salmonella enterica absent in 25 gram. Canned shrimps, sardine TPC should be nil, E. coli absent in 25 gram, and Staphylococcus absent in 25 gram, and pathogens also absent in 25 gram. Contaminants and toxic residues. Contaminants are substances not intentionally added to food, but they are present or added to an article of food during production at farm level or processing, preparation, storage and transport as a result of environment contamination, which make food unsafe. For example, metal contamination and naturally occurring toxic substances. There are 9 metal contaminants such as lead, zinc, copper, arsenic, cadmium, mercury, methyl, mercury, chromium, limit of which are prescribed in the regulations. There are 4 crop contaminants, aflatoxin, M1, botulin and orchatoxins, limit of which are also prescribed. There are 4 naturally occurring substances like agaric acid, hydrocyanic acid, hypercinic acid and safrole, limit of which are prescribed in the regulations. There are 149 pesticide residues having different groups like organophosphorus, organochlorine, cardamite, synthetic pyrethroids, limit of which are prescribed for each regulations. As there are some limit for metal contaminant like lead, juices, beverages is 0.05 ppm, canned foods and jam 1 ppm, milk products is 0.2 ppm, sugars and cocoa powder 5 ppm, and all other foods 2.5 ppm. Arsenic also and another very highly toxic contaminants for beverage, ice cream, it is 0.5 ppm, milk 0.1 ppm, dehydrated onion 2 ppm, carbonated water 0.2 ppm, turmeric powder 0.1 ppm, and all other foods 1.1 ppm. Similarly, mercury is also a very highly toxic metals. For fish, it is 0.5 ppm, and other foods 1 ppm. Methyl mercury for all food, it is highly toxic, it is limit is 0.25 ppm. Similarly, for crop contaminants, aflatoxin for all food 30 ppm, aflatoxin M1 for milk 0.5 ppm, plotulin apple juice 50 ppm, and orchatoxin A for wheat and barley 20 ppm. Naturally occurring substances like agaric acid, food containing mushroom or alcoholic beverages 100 ppm, hydrocyanic acid, canned stone fruits and confectionery 5 ppm, and hypercyanine alcoholic beverages 1 ppm, safrole, meat and fish products is 10 ppm. With this, I conclude my presentation with a remark that all food business operators engaged in manufacturing of food products should ensure that products are manufactured meeting the standards and safety requirements prescribed under the regulations. Thank you.